All right, it's no secret, everyone loves online shopping, but when it comes to photography, is it really the best way to go? We're gonna dig into that right now. Hey guys, welcome back. All right, a little story time to start the video. So I grew up outside of Baltimore, and I remember in high school when I started getting into photography as kind of a hobby, my parents would bring me to this place called Service Photo. Now, Service Photo was and still is Baltimore's like the place to go get camera equipment. It's the photo store in Baltimore. And I just remember being so excited every time that they took me to go check it out because yes, they had all these crazy fancy lenses and gear and equipment that I had never seen before, but also I think the reason that those memories just stick out so much for me was because of the people who worked there. Every time I went, it was like an experience and a conversation that I was having with these really cool people that were working there behind the counter. They always took the time to ask my name, ask me how it was going with my portfolio, how my classes were going, what I was interested in, what my goals were, what I was trying to accomplish within photography. And I just thought that was really cool as a young photographer to have this community there that I was able to walk into from time to time. Well, fast forward a year or two, I got my first summer job as a print tech and sales associate for Ritz Camera. Now, some of you who were maybe around in the 90s and early 2000s probably remember Ritz Camera as the place to get your prints made, your 4x6s, your 5x7s. So I was the guy in the back of the lab making those prints happen for you. And while I didn't end up having a career in photo sales, I do remember that being such a great experience for really the same reason. And that was seeing those relationships happen between staff and between customer in a brick and mortar location as a place to come together to talk about photography and see that community kind of grow. All right, but enough nostalgia, let's get real for a second. We all know in 2021, online shopping is super easy, super convenient. We can get on Amazon or somewhere else, and with one click of a button, you've got anything that you need delivered to your doorstep the next day or sometimes even the same day. But for the purposes of this video, I kind of wanted to unpack the other side of the business when it comes to photography, and that is shopping locally. Now, anyone who followed this channel knows that I do have a fantastic relationship with Hunt's Photo and Video. They are New England's top photo and video retailer. And honestly, genuinely, since I moved to Boston in 2012, they have been a huge help for me in my professional development as a photographer. So I wanted to bring in a few guests from Hunt's to kind of talk through this discussion of shopping locally when it comes to photography gear and equipment. So joining me in a Zoom call right now are a couple guests from Hunt's. We've got the CEO, Scott Farber, and the Director of Retail Sales and Operations, John Lawton. Guys, thank you so much for joining me here on the channel.
Oh, thanks for having us.
From your perspective, how has the industry in general changed in the past decade or so? What are the changes that you are going through, and what are kind of the benefits and the drawbacks of each of those changes?
Well, our industry has changed a lot over the last decade. If you go back 10 years ago and look at the photo industry, you're talking about an industry that in the United States was selling 35 million cameras a year. It was a huge industry. It was in every major retailer, Walmart, Best Buy, Targets. It was everywhere. Today, as phones have taken over the, let's call it the lower end market for the most part, you know, this country sells typically now about 2 or 3 million cameras a year. I mean, it has shrunk exponentially in the last 10 years, but it's changed. It's become something for people to do. It's not a necessity to go take pictures with cameras. It's something people want to do. So it's changed our business dramatically from what it was 10 years ago, where we were just selling cameras to every person who was going on a vacation, having a new baby, getting married, you know. It's changed a lot.
Does it still kind of even out online versus store? How does that breakdown kind of look?
Hunt's as a business has always been a heavier brick and mortar type business, where we do more business in our store than we do online. The online business has grown a lot over the last handful of years. And with COVID, it's just grown a lot in the past, you know, couple of months, you know, months of COVID. It's really just exploded. I think everyone assumed it, you know, it would. There's definitely more consumers that are shopping online. But we still find that there's a lot of people that before making such a large purchase, like a camera or expensive lens or something or lighting, want to come in and try it out first, talk to people, you know, first, just have a conversation.
For me, you know, having been a customer of yours for many years now, that my favorite part is going into the store, because there's just such a great experience. Can you guys talk about the in-store experience that you provide and how that benefits people who are interested in photography?
Customer base, as Scott mentioned, really varies from, you know, entry-level customer to professional, and across the board, they all have a need to, you know, come in and kind of lay hands on equipment, see what is, you know, sometimes brand new to the market, things that aren't available besides reading about specs online. Like, you know, now every time you go buy a product, it's customary to go read an online review of something. And the customers that come in the store can get basically their own firsthand review of how things work through one of our associates at the store, troubleshoot a problem. That's really where we can set ourselves apart.
I view Hunts as not just a camera store, but a photography community. Like, yes, I can go to your store and buy a camera or a lens or lighting or whatever I need, but I also think, I feel that there's so many resources there to help photographers learn, to gather, to talk, to show off work. What do you guys think about that? Why is it kind of important that it's not just a store, but also a community?
Shopping and the shopping experience is about giving a customer a really good use of their time. People's time right now in today's world is so stretched thin, and people just don't have the amount of free time that they once did. If someone comes into the store, we want to make sure that time they spend with us is really a good use of their time. It's a good experience. That means that if they're talking to our salespeople, we want our salespeople to be able to talk to them intelligently, to speak to them at their level, so they can explain or show them products, that they can just talk to them about what kind of photography are they doing and be able to engage in that. To help fuel that passion people have, to help educate. The customers that we have, that we see that come in our store, have become it's a much more passionate customer base that just loves photography, loves taking pictures, wants to do more, wants to learn more. And it's been a very enjoyable thing to be able to experience that.
Is a big part of the business just following the trends of the industry, like, you know, the shift from film to digital and then digital to DSLR, DSLR to mirrorless? Are you guys trying to always stay ahead of the next thing that's coming, the next wave or fad that's coming?
If you watch like bloggers out there and vloggers out there, everyone's always trying to predict what's gonna happen. Who's gonna be successful? Who's gonna be this? And sometimes they're right, sometimes they're wrong. So I don't think we try to stay ahead of it. But when the change is happening, we don't sit back and wait. We make the change on the spot as it's happening. If there's a new camera out there or a new lens brand out there that we see people, this is going to be popular. People are asking for this. We jump right on it. We make sure we, you know, bring it in right away and change what, you know, and have it in stock on so people can borrow it and put it into our rental department so people can rent it. We're very quick to adapt things like that.
I think the size company we are and as open we are to listening to our staff, like Scott had mentioned, if there's some sort of product they're getting asked about, you know, day after day, or getting phone calls about saying, hey, do you carry this? Is this something that I can get there? Like, we're committed to purchasing those on a, you know, just see if it'll work, try it out, see if this new product line is going to be successful for us. Because if our customers are asking for it and we don't have it, they're going to end up buying it somewhere else anyway. So we might as well invest the time in bringing it in. So it's kind of seeing what is new, hot, important, and then making sure we're, you know, staying in the conversation with what those products are and having them in our stores.
John, education is definitely a part of all of this that we've been talking about. Tell me about the education piece within the store and also the programming that you have out in the area.
Yeah, the education department has really taken us to new levels, particularly, you know, during the COVID situation currently now, and they offer many different types of education. We do, you know, via the web right now, classes that are topic-based, type of photography-based with an instructor where a group of people can, you know, sign in, view them, take the classes, and even view them after the fact. And we're still offering our photo walks, which are, in person, put on outdoors with a group of folks and a Hunts instructor or two Hunts instructors. And they've really helped forge this group or club of just photography enthusiasts that are, you know, helping fuel this engagement in photography. And that's something that you see. It's exciting to watch. It's exciting to see people be just really pumped up about photography. And it's great for our business.
As an example, a good way that represents what we do is, if you go back 5 years ago, we had some people that worked for us that were like, I think I'd like to teach our customers and teach a class about photography. And at the time we were like, well, it doesn't make a lot of sense. Like, there's photo schools all over the place in the Boston area and in New England. And we were like, why would someone want to go to Hunts to take a photo class? They can go to some of the most prestigious photo places in the world that existed in our area that were, you know, you could take class at. But we slowly, you know, we're like, yeah, well, let's try it out. Let's get into it. And we brought in some of these really great, talented people to teach photography. And now we've got, you know, stores with classrooms. Of course, most of these photo schools have closed, and Hunts has become like a premier photo educator in the New England area, if not in the country, because now we do all of our, of course, with COVID, we do all of our classes online. And that's just being willing to try something, to be adaptable and sticking with it and just, you know, turning out to be a very successful thing for us.
So for the folks listening, I think, you know, what Scott just said is super important. And I personally can attest to that, having worked with Hunts for a long time now. I've been to the store for photo shows, photo gallery exhibits, openings. I've been for classes. We've had partnerships with Hunts to have photo night at Fenway Park, where people can come to Fenway and take photos on the field and work with Hunts to work on their cameras and lenses and everything like that. And so these are all, what I'm trying to say is, these are all things that you're not going to get on Amazon, you know, and that's where I think just, it's a real community. And I think in this era where everything is automated and online, it's just so refreshing to be able to work with actual people, talk about a passion that we all share, which is making images and the gear that goes into it. And that's what I gain out of you guys and that experience. So for the people listening, it's true, and it really is a community. So it's very special.
So there you have it, guys. Definitely an interesting conversation, and for sure some food for thought when it comes to that next purchase you are thinking about making, whether that's Hunts for you in New England or whatever your local camera store is, wherever you are located in the world. Just give it some thought before you make that one-time easy click purchase on Amazon. Now, I want to put a disclaimer out there. Hunts isn't paying me to make this video, guys. I just genuinely believe that within the photography market, there is still a great place for local shops because of the community that it fosters and the ability that it brings for people to come together to talk about photography and grow and develop the industry together. That is the sell, and I just genuinely believe that. Photography stores have always been a part of my career ever since the very beginning, and I want to just make sure that continues to happen. So I hope you guys found this video interesting, found it thoughtful and helpful. If you have any questions at all, please drop them in the comments down below. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Give this video a thumbs up. We are pushing along with more content. I will see you guys at the next one.